Hey, it's Anthony. I was asked about Sozo ministry and what it was and if it's actually biblical. And so there's a bunch of stuff you can actually research online now. Back to 2013 is probably some of the earliest articles I've seen. But from what I know about Sozo ministry and people I know who've gone through it, what they don't realize is that it's psychology dressed up in Christianity. So it's dressed up with the terminology of Christianese. It's dressed up with all these things that we're going to make you better. We're going to make your old man better. And it completely misses the work of the Holy Spirit and His Word and Jesus Christ in your life, that He's made you a new creation. So why are you trying to fix up the old creation when you're a new creation? So they use different techniques in psychology, which is also called mesmerism. You need to look that up. It's actually very demonic. It has nothing to do with God. And they're trying to bring this junk into the church. So I can definitely tell you to your answer, it is not biblical, okay? Because God didn't come to try to rejuvenate and restore an old thing. It says the old is passed away. The old self is dead, it's gone. And we have a new self in Christ Jesus. He's made us a new creation in Christ Jesus. So we can see exactly what Scripture says, and it completely destroys the narrative of all these tools that they use. And they also employ different New Age tactics, such as projectionism, right? So that basically you think about a memory that you've been in, and you know, something very bad, something tragic. Well, maybe you know your uncle was raping you or something like that, and just imagine Jesus right there. Jesus is right next to you. And it's a Freudian tactic. It's psychology. Has no real bearing in the spirit. The only thing it does is it opens you up to possession and demonic possession and oppression. So it's not good. My suggestion is stay away. Like, look at it. Look at what the Bible honestly teaches instead of what they're trying to tell you it teaches. And if this was had any bearing, if it had any real bearing, then how come Jesus didn't teach it? So follow the simple principle. If Jesus did it, do it. If He did not do it, then you don't do it. It's very simple. Don't make it more complicated than what it is, and you'll see that it exposes all the lies. It exposes false doctrines and traditions of man. And I can say that Sozo, all it is psychologists trying to make their way and make a living in the church, because they understand, with an understanding of the new creation in you, then that puts them out of a job, because they can't counsel you, because they want to work on your old creation. They want to work on your old nature instead of who Jesus has made you. And when it's talking about looking at scriptures and beholding who's the Word of God, Jesus, right? And that we look like Him is what another scripture says. So if we turn away and forget what we look like, then we fall. We make mistakes. We make issues. Like, there's issues that are born out of it. But if we look in the scripture and we see who we are in Christ Jesus and what He's created us to be and how we're supposed to walk and how we're supposed to talk, and it's no longer an acting, because you're not trying to do it out of your own struggles or striving. It's the understanding of His nature, and His nature abiding and living in you by the Holy Spirit that sets you free from the law of sin and death. You can find that in Romans 8. You can look in Romans 3. You look in Romans 4. So we're no longer slaves of sin, but of righteousness. We're slaves of righteousness. We can't help but do it righteous because we have a new nature. And so it's very important that you see it from that perspective instead of what the world and the ungodly church is trying to feed you. God bless you. Remember, be the gospel.